to another fun, fast, and fabulous tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to create your own long shadow type effect. So let's dig in. I'm Kara Plichenich, and I help creatives up their game with inspiration and know-how. Here, you'll find beginner-friendly projects and tutorials for Photoshop, photography, design, and more. Be sure to check the description below for any links or free downloads mentioned in this video, and hit me up at karaplichenich.com to check out my full library of in-depth courses. And while you're there, grab my free creative toolkit, an ever-growing collection of Photoshop actions, templates, design assets, and more. First thing I want to do is create some guides so we know the proper angle to have the shadow come off at, and so that the shadow will match from one letter to the next. It just takes out a lot of guesswork. So I'm going to draw the guides using the line tool. So this is part of the shape tool family, so you can press the letter U on your keyboard to grab the shape tool family, and then select the line tool. And up here in the options bar, I've got it set to shape. It has a fill that I'm gonna make something purple or like a fuchsia so I can see it easily. I don't have a stroke at the moment, and I've got my weight set to 3 pixels. So these settings will vary depending on the resolution of your image. So you just have to experiment and see what's gonna work for you. So now that we have the line tool selected, we want to think about which angle and which direction we want the shadow to go. In this case, I want the shadow to come off down and to the left at a 45 degree angle. So what we can do is with our line tool, I'm just going to click and drag upwards to the right while I'm holding down the shift key. And you can see that that creates a line at a perfect 45 degree angle. Holding down the shift key constrains the line to 45 degree increments. So if I wanted a perfectly horizontal line, I could hold shift and drag this way. And then you can see that it swings around in 45 degree increments. All right, so now that we have this line, I'm gonna switch to my move tool by pressing V for move. And I'm gonna drag this here and position it off the W so I can see where this needs to go. And I'm going to need another one off the point up here. So with that shape layer still selected, I'm going to hold down the Alt or Option key, and then I'm going to drag to the right, and I'm holding Shift to keep it aligned. And I'm gonna do that again, hold Option, Shift, and drag over here so I can see where that needs to go. Again, Option, and positioning these in place. And if you have a hard time getting it in the right spot, you can also use your arrow keys with the Move tool to get that in position. Now we're ready to draw this shape, using these lines as our guide. So to make it easy to see what we are doing, I'm gonna target the background layer, and that way when I click to start drawing the shape, it will appear below the wow layer, so we'll be able to still see the W on top of our work. Okay, so we're ready for the pen tool, so I'm gonna press P for pen. And up in the control panel, I want to make sure that I have shape selected. And for the fill color, I'm going to choose this kind of retro red color. And I'm not going to have a stroke. And that's it. Now we are ready to do this. So I know that not everyone is like in love with the pen tool, and that's okay. This is easy and you can do this. So here's how it's gonna look like. We're gonna start with the bottom right corner of this W. And with the pen tool, you can see that there's a little asterisk in the bottom right corner of the pen tool icon. And that indicates that we are about to create a new shape. So that's perfect. So I'm gonna position my tip of my pen right here at the edge of the W, and I'm gonna click. That's it, just a click. And now I'm going to position, I'll drag my pen over here. I'm not pressing anything. So I've just clicked and let go. Now I'm going to move my pen down here following this line and even maybe a little outside the boundaries here. And I'm going to click once again. I'll click around in what I call outer space out here. Then I want to come over here and make sure I line up with this line. So I'll click over here. And you'll notice that as we click, Photoshop is creating the segments between these points. So what's cool about this is we don't have to worry about drawing curves with the pen tool, which is where things get a little more intense. We are just clicking. So this is really the same thing as if we used the polygonal lasso tool, for example. However, unlike the lasso tool, when we do it with the pen tool, we can grab these points and move them if we need to. So this gives us more flexibility. Okay, now we're going to come up here and click off the corner of this W. And then I'm going to come down here and click this corner. Come up here and click to this point. And again down here to this point. And again over here. See what I'm saying? And now we just need to close this path the same way you would do with any selection, or in this case, shape. And that is to return to the starting point. And you'll notice if I just hover my cursor over it, I get a little circle next to my pen tool. And if you've ever used some of the other shape drawing tools before, you will recognize that that circle means that if I click here, Photoshop is going to close the shape. So, or the path. So here I can now click and that shape is complete. See, that was not too hard, was it? And now over here we see that we have shape two, because all of these were shape one. These are our guidelines. And we have shape two here. And now we're ready to draw a separate shape for the O. So we need to move our guidelines over. So I'm going to switch back to the move tool by pressing V for move. And I'll just grab one of these guidelines. It doesn't really matter which one. They're all at 45 degree angles. And I'm just going to drag this over and I want to line it up to wherever it hits the outside of the O. So right there. And then I'll grab another one of the already existing guidelines and drag it over to where it hits the O over here. And this is so handy because if I was just like eyeballing this, which you could also do, but I feel like I'm not sure I would get the angle just right. So this makes it like pretty idiot proof. Okay, now we're ready to draw our next shape, shadow. And to do that, I'm going to come back to layer zero again because I want this next layer to be behind the W shadow. So this O shadow, I want it behind the W shadow. So maybe I can rename this W shadow. So double click and then you can type in a new name. And because Photoshop always creates new layers on top of whatever layer was previously selected, that's why I want to target the background. Okay, so I am ready to grab my pen tool again. This time I'm going to choose a yellow color, so something like this for the fill. So still set to shape, yellow fill, bottom layer selected. We are ready to draw. So again, we see our pen tool that has the little asterisk. So I'm going to click right, just where the O intersects with the line. So I'll click right here and I'll follow the line out into the abyss down here and I'll come around the edge. Doesn't really matter where you click out here. We're just getting the shape out. And now I can see this line's right here. It is kind of hard to see with that red shadow. So, you know, if you need to hide that, you can hide that. Then just make sure you're clicking on the right line. And then I need to bring this all the way back up to the O right here. And I also need to cover the counter in the O. So the hole in the O needs to be filled with this shape too. So I'm just gonna click over here to get around that. and come back and close the shape again right where we started by clicking here. That's it. Then we can turn this shape back on. And we're actually done with all of our guides now. So these were these shape lines here. So I'm going to get rid of those. So I'll click to select one and shift click the rest, hit delete. And now here's what's cool, because this word has two W's, so they're going to have the same shadow. So we don't have to redraw this even. We can duplicate the W shadow by pressing Command or Control J. And then let's double click to rename it, and we'll call it W2 shadow. And I can, while we're at it, rename this one down here, O shadow. And I'm gonna take the second W, the W2 shadow, and I'm gonna drag it down in the layers panel until I see this blue line here in between the O shadow and the bottom layer. And then if I drop it, it will move into that position. Now we don't see it over there yet because we just changed the stacking order. The shadow is still on top of the other one right over here. So to move it, I need to switch to my move tool. So again, V for move, and I'm gonna hold down the shift key to keep it in alignment, and I'm gonna drag it until it lines up over here. Now this is going to be a perfect example of why we do this with the pen tool. So before we fix this down here, let's change the color. So I'm gonna grab the P for pen tool and we'll change this to this fun aqua color. So because this shadow is selected and I have the pen tool selected, I can come up and I can just change the color right here and it will update that shape on the currently selected layer. Now here's where it's so easy to edit this. So we've drawn this path. You can see the path outline here. What we need to do is move this point, and I guess this one too. We need to pull them down further to fill in this space. So anytime we have this existing path that we want to edit, we need to use the path selection or the direct selection tool. In this case, because we only want to select certain points on the path, not the path as a whole, just certain points, we want the direct selection tool because this allows us to directly edit individual points. So with that selected, I can come over here and click on this point, and I could shift click on this point, and we see that these two points are now blue while the other points are white. So that indicates that these two points are selected. And now I can just click even this bar right here, and I'm going to hold shift to keep the angle the same and just drag it off the document. And then I can just click away or switch to a different tool to set that. So how perfect is that? We created this cool long shadow effect that is all the rage right now. And I love the colors, and of course I'm a Hamilton nerd, so that is the inspiration for this phrase, which makes, of course, even more sense when we include a little crown here. And if you follow a lot of my tutorials, you know that I love the shapes too. So I'm gonna go grab a custom shape to finish this off. I'll press U for the shape tool family. And then in the toolbar, I can come down and choose custom shape tool. And if I come up here to the control panel with the custom shape tool selected, and I click this drop down, there are lots of shapes here that we can use. And remember, if you see something different here, just click your cogwheel and you can change what shapes you're looking at and how they are displayed. But I'm gonna scroll down until I find this crown right here, of course, like King George in the musical, and I'll set the options in the control panel to shape, just like we did with the pen tool. I'll select a fill, in this case, white. Oop. This is where it gets a little tricky because it turned white because I had this layer selected. So again, I'm gonna target the background layer. And now when I select white, it won't do that. And with the crown selected, white fill, bottom layer selected, I can now hold shift and drag to make this crown. And I just think that is truly fun. So we can keep it as a flat design like this, or we could apply a matchbook type texture. And I have a really cool action for that. So what I'm going to do is copy a merged version of all of this. So instead of flattening it and then copying it, if I press Command or Control A, it puts a selection around everything. And then if I press Command Shift C, let's see, edit, copy, merge. Yes, Command Shift C or Control Shift C. That will copy everything as if everything was merged. Then I can go into this cool document here and open up the smart object. And now I can paste in my design by pressing Command or Control V. And then I'll save it and close it. And now we have this wonderful textured effect. And there's actually different versions. We can have a chipboard effect or a paperboard, hardboard, or manila. So there you have it, a simple hand-drawn way to create the ever-popular long shadow type effect. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you again at the next tutorial.